Yeah, good afternoon everyone and welcome to Corporate Finance online classes. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Monjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. Okay, so dear students, in the previous class we completed chapter number one, Financial Management and Overview. Okay, now today we are going to make a beginning to learn chapter number two, okay, the time value of money. So in last part of the chapter number one, we learned about objectives of financial management. And the second alternative was wealth maximization of shareholders. So we considered wealth maximization, the objective of wealth maximization of shareholders is superior to the objective of profit maximization, because the objective of wealth maximization takes into account or takes into consideration the timing of benefits and the quality of benefits. So when we say timing of benefits, okay, this alternative of wealth maximization approach takes into account the concept of time value of money. It means the 1 rupee earned today, the value of the rupee earned today will not be same after some years, because rupee loses value over a period of time. Okay. So this concept we are going to learn today, and we are also going to solve numericals as to how to do it. Okay, before I begin the chapter, so though in the first class I mentioned to you that in the semester end examination, there will be 7 questions of 20 marks each. Question number 1 to 6, you have to answer any 4 full questions. Okay, and question number 7 compulsory case study. So total 7 questions, 7 set of questions with 20 marks each. Total marks are 140. You have to answer maximum 100 questions, 100 mark questions. So out of 140 total marks, only 40 marks will be of theory. Remaining 100 marks will be of numericals. Okay, as I said, in every entire MBA program, this is a subject with the highest percentage of numericals. So what you would be doing when I solve problems? You'll simply, okay, look at me, stare at me, okay, like theory classes, or is it good if you note down the sums and solve the numericals along with me? What is the good practice in numerical subject?
Sir, we will solve along with
you. Solving, sir.
We need to solve, sir.
Right? Yeah, my pace will be moderate. You'll be able to solve the numericals along with me so that you understand it better. Okay, because for numericals, definitely you need to solve. Then for today's class, how many of you have notebooks ready?
Yes, sir.
I am ready, sir.
I'm ready, sir.
Okay, yeah, it stopped. Less than 15 students in the class are ready with a notebook. Now, other students, yes, what you do is, you manage some pen and a old notebook or papers. Okay. Okay. Yeah, you can arrange it for 10 minutes. Okay. There are some couple of slides which I will explain. So before I arrive at the numerical, you arrange your notebook or paper and pen. Okay. Then those who have made a fair notebook, okay, very good. I really like that attitude. Keep it up. And those who don't have a fair notebook, you have to make a fair notebook by tomorrow. If you don't have a provision to purchase a fair notebook, then just look at the possible options. Okay, don't please make the notebook as a garbage or a rough notebook, or write some into pieces of paper, throw it somewhere. Later you won't be able to find them. Even if you write in papers, you can keep on stapling them after each chapter. Each chapter you should go on stapling, so that, and you maintain it properly in some cupboard. Okay, but a better thing is a notebook. Okay, so this is the background. Then second requirement is a time value tables. I already shared them in Google Classroom and instructed you. Wherever possible, please take printout. Now absolutely if not possible, then okay, maintain the soft copy in some other device which you can refer, okay, while solving the numericals. Remember, chapter number 2, whole of unit number 2, whole of unit number 3. You cannot solve numericals without time value tables. So those who will not get an access, those who will not refer the tables, those who will ignore my instructions, will not learn. Remember. And final, those who do not maintain fair notebook and those who will not have, not refer, I have already shared, I will not say not have, those who will not refer time value tables along with me will definitely fail in examination. There is no doubt about it. Huh? Let me tell you. So all the year students have religiously, okay, students have religiously followed my instructions, maintained a fair notebook, maintained and referred the time value tables. Okay, so along with that, one more important thing is calculator. Okay, so now mobile phones and laptops or desktops also have a calculator, but you see how you can use them. Or if you have a separate calculator also, it is very good. So for my class, henceforth, a fair notebook. The next is time value tables. Third is a calculator. How and in which format, it is up to you. Okay, so anybody who will attend the classes with these three things, okay, can score up to 100 out of 100. Remember, huh? Because purely there is 100 marks of numericals in the semester end exam, only 40 marks theory. Okay, so those who are very confident can attempt all numerical problems only. So with these instructions, okay, let me begin the class now. So you will have another 5 to 10 minutes to arrange your notebook. So do not waste much time. Concept understanding is also required. So first let me share the PowerPoint slide, give some basic idea to the concept of time value of money. So students, can you see this PowerPoint slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So chapter number 2, okay, we are going to learn about the time value of money. Okay. So a very simple idea, if I tell you, okay, like say if you have purchased petrol, for example, okay, 2 years before, what are the price of petrol? A rough idea is okay. Rough idea.
70.
Okay, 78 around. You will round it off to 80 rupees.
77, sir.
We'll round it off to 80 rupees. Okay. Now, what is the present price of petrol?
94.
We'll round it to 100 rupees. We'll round it off to 100 rupees. Okay. So, say, imagine you have 80 rupees in your pocket. Okay. So, let us, those who have seen time travel movie or time travel series, you can understand that. So, there are two of my students. Okay. One is in the past 2 years. Okay, and one is in present. Okay, so future. So both have 80 rupees. Both have 80 rupees only. Or let us say two students from the past 2 years ago, one has traveled to future after 2 years, and both have 80 rupees. So he has carried 80 rupees from the past. Now both go to fuel station, let us imagine. Okay, gas station or a petrol pump. So 2 years ago, that student with 80 rupees, how much petrol he will be able to purchase?
1 liter.
Okay. Now a student from same time has traveled into future with 80 rupees, where the petrol price is 100 rupees. How much he will be able to purchase?
800 ml.
800 ml only. See, but both have 80 rupees, no? Why one is able to buy 1000 ml or 1 liter of petrol and another is not able to buy 1000 ml of petrol? Only 800 ml he is able to buy.
The value of rupee has decreased.
Yeah, excellent. Okay, so rupee has lost its value over a period of 2 years. Okay, so now we know that the 80 rupees 2 years ago and 80 rupees 2 years after, though they look 80 rupees, are they same? Are they equal?
No,
very good. They are not, though they look 8080, but they are not the same. 80 rupees 2 years ago has more value than 80 rupees after 2 years. So imagine, okay, so if somebody tells you, okay, you give me 80 rupees and I will return 80 rupees to you after 2 years, is it a profitable deal?
No, sir.
It's a loss for you. Imagine, though he may return you 80 rupees promptly after 2 years, but 2 years ago you would have purchased one full liter of petrol. But when you receive your money from your friend after 2 years, with the same 80 rupee, you will not be able to buy 1 liter of petrol. You can buy only 800 ml of petrol. So I hope you are able to understand. If your friend is asking you, say you will return me 80 rupees, you give me 80 rupees today, I will return you 80 rupees after 2 years. So how are you going to compare 80 rupees today and 80 rupees to be received after 2 years? There should be a fair comparison, right? So how you will bring down 80 rupees of after 80 rupees to be received after 2 years has to be discounted back to its original value 2 years ago. That is the concept what we are going to learn in time value of money. So 80 rupees in future, present day, if you discount it, it may become like 72 rupees or 75 rupees. Remember that. So though if you have not understood, but this is what we are going to learn in theory, and also we are going to solve numericals. So the concept will be clear, absolutely no problem. But before starting the theory, I thought I'll give you some analogy or a situation to bring you to a common platform. So in this chapter, we are going to learn, okay, the concept of time value of money, what is the rationale or logic behind the using the concept of time value of money, and what are the techniques, okay, what are the techniques of comparing two values, okay, from different time periods. Then also practical applications of compounding and present value techniques. So let me begin with the idea of what time value of money is. A financial decision taken today has implications for a number of years. Firms pay, okay, which we call them as cash outflows. Firms pay for the assets purchased in present. And the benefits received by such assets are spread over a number of years in future. Firms procure funds from sources like new issues, bank borrowing, etc., which we call them as cash inflows. Now let me explain. Say a company has decided to purchase a machine. A company has decided to purchase a machine worth, antibiotic making machine, fully automatic machine. Okay, I saw one fully automatic machine that makes antibiotic. It's an old antibiotic. I don't remember the name of that antibiotic. In Karnataka Antibiotics, okay, Bangalore plant. It used to make an antibiotic 100% automatic. Only at the one end, they feed the raw materials and vials, empty vials. And at the other end, you'll find humans where the medicine, it actually injection powder form, it comes with a sealed vial and a label on it. Okay, so I asked the price, he said 1 crore rupee, the price of the machine was. So firms pay for the assets purchased in present. So when Karnataka Antibiotics company decided to purchase that fully automatic antibiotic making machine, it paid 1 crore rupee that year in which it purchased. And the benefits received by such assets are spread over a number of years in future. Okay, so since last maybe 25 or 30 years, even now this year also, Karnataka Antibiotics is producing or manufacturing antibiotics, okay, using that machine. Means every year that machine generates revenue for the company. Okay, in future, so benefits are received by such assets, that antibiotic making machine, are spread over a number of years in the future. So year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4, year 5, year 10, year 20, okay. The company is receiving benefits. Company makes medicines using that machine. They sell it in the market and cash inflows happen. Okay. So I hope you understand this example. So financial decisions are made on the basis of a comparison of such cash inflows and cash outflows. So what are the cash outflow? Cost of the machine, which the company paid 1 crore rupees. What are cash inflows? Okay, the company using that machine makes its product, sells it in the market and earns revenue every year. Those are cash inflows. So financial decision here is whether to purchase the machine or not. Okay, so financial decisions are nothing but whether to purchase the machine or not. Okay, so whether to purchase the machine or not, such a decision is made on the basis of a comparison of such cash inflows and cash outflows. I hope till here, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Now, second part of it.
For a meaningful comparison, the two must be strictly comparable. Now pay attention. I gave you a situation of 80 rupees. 80 rupees 2 years ago and 80 rupees 2 years after. are not equal in value, are not equal in value, right? So you cannot compare. If your friend says, I will return you 80 rupees after 2 years, it means he is returning lesser benefits to you. He took more benefits from you, he is returning lesser benefits to you. So you should not accept his offer. Okay, you should not accept his offer because you will incur a loss. Because with the same 80 rupee, okay, you will not be able to purchase 1 liter petrol after 2 years. So for a meaningful comparison of the cash inflows and cash outflows, okay, cash outflow, cost of the machine paid by the company happens in present, but cash inflows, okay, revenue from using the machine happen over a period of time in future. So what you are going to earn, what the machine is, what revenues the machine is going to generate in future, okay, are not equally valued, okay, what has spent in present. So the future income has to be discounted to the present value, then only it becomes comparable. So for a meaningful comparison of the two must be strictly comparable. To compare the cash inflows that accrue at different time periods in future, it is necessary to convert the sums of money into a common point in time. So we convert the future sums to present sum by giving some discount. Okay, so this discounting of the future income to present value is enabled by incorporating the time element in calculations. And this is nothing but time value of money. Okay, so time value of money means that the value of a unit of money is different in different time periods. Like the value of a sum of money received today is more than its value received after some time. The time value of money is expressed in terms of a rate of return or a discount rate. Okay, so anybody who is not able to understand what is the concept of time value of money, or at least the concept that a rupee earned today is more valuable than a rupee earned tomorrow. That is what it says. That's it. And if you have to compare both the rupees, you have to discount the future rupee so that you can compare it with its present rupee. Okay, anybody who is not able to understand, any doubts, any further clarifications required? Okay, so there is silence. So I hope students are able to understand. Okay, then we said that the value of a sum of money received today is more than its value received after some time. Okay, so to compare the cash flows that accrue at different time periods, it is necessary to convert the sums of money to a common point in time. So how the sums of money of different time periods are converted to a common point in time, that is through these techniques. You should also know what are these techniques. These techniques enable a manager to convert the sums of money to a common point in time that have occurred in different time periods. Okay, so you will not only learn the numericals, but you will also learn the interpretation, the application, and the meaning, and how they are used in financial management for decision making. Okay, so everything you will learn. It's not just about arriving at an answer. Sir, is it answer correct? Answer is right. Answer is wrong. No. Interpretation, application, and decision making. Everything is involved in this numerical problems. Okay, so there are the techniques that convert the sums from different time periods to a common point in time are broadly classified into two. One is compounding technique, another is discounting technique. Okay, so I have shared you reading material for chapter unit one, I think. Okay, so those who have read it, does it contain these techniques also? Anybody who has read the reading materials?
No, sir.
It does not contain for this, right? Okay, was it Suman who spoke?
Yes, sir.
So it is only of chapter one, right?
Sir. Wealth maximization and
yes, no problem. Okay. Profit. Yeah, so now in compounding technique, okay, so a present rupee will be converted into its future value. In compounding technique, a present value will be converted into its future value. For example, your cumulative deposit, fixed deposit, for example, 100, okay, let's say 1 lakh rupee put in a fixed deposit today at the rate of 8% interest. How much would it become after 1 year? So 1 lakh rupee plus 8% of interest you have to add. Let us say the interest is credited once in a year. So what is the 8% of 1 lakh rupees?
8,000 rupees.
Okay. So the future value of 1 lakh rupee deposited today after 1 year is 1,08,000 rupees.
8,000.
Okay. So how you will make a decision? Say your friend will say, "Oh, dear friend, I'm in some need. Give me 1 lakh rupee this year. I will return you 1 lakh rupee next year." Is it a profitable offer?
Yes, sir.
Your friend will ask you, "Dear friend, give me 1 lakh rupee this year. I will return 1 lakh rupees after 1 year. Is it a profitable offer?"
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, because the 1 lakh rupee value will not remain as 1 lakh after 1 year. Okay. So if you really want the equal amount, you don't want to any profit from your friend, you should tell your friend, "See, if I deposit the same amount in bank, I will earn 8% interest. The total amount after 1 year is 1,08,000 rupees. So if you borrow 1 lakh rupee from me today, you should return me 1,08,000 after 1 year. Then it's an equal offer. Since he's a friend, you don't want to make profit. But if you are not a friend, you are lending money to earn interest or profit. Okay. So you should ask 1 lakh rupee you should lend today. But in return, you should ask more money from him, like 1,10,000, 1,15,000 rupees after 1 year. Okay. So whatever you earn off above 1,08,000 rupees will be your profit. So if you get 1,10,000 rupees in return, 2,000 rupees your profit. Okay. If you receive 1,15,000 rupees after 1 year from that person, okay, you will have a profit of 7,000 rupees. Remember this. Okay. So in compounding technique, we convert the present sums into future sums. Okay, and this future value is calculated for a single cash flow as well as for a annuity. What is annuity? I'll explain you at that point in time. Okay. And the single cash flow, for single cash flow, interest may be credited once in a year. We call it annual compounding. Interest may be credited twice in a year, 6 monthly. We call it semi-annual compounding. Or interest may be credited 4 times in a year. We call it quarterly compounding. So we are going to calculate or convert the present sum into future sum in all these situations. Okay. And the second technique to convert the sums of money earned in different point of time to one common point is a discounting technique, where we convert the future sum into present sum. Where we convert the future sums into present sum. So there are three situations where we convert the future sums into present sum. First is present value of a single cash flow. Okay, say for example, after 5 years, you are going to receive 5 lakh rupees. What is its value today? Okay, you can find out present value of an annuity. Okay, so annuity is nothing but equal annual cash flows. Equal annual cash flows. So every year, if you are going to receive, okay, 1 lakh rupees every year for 10 years. You can also calculate the value of that to present. Present value of perpetuity. Okay. Some amount which you are going to receive for lifetime. Best example is pension. Best example is pension. Every month or every year, the employee, retired employee, goes on receiving some amount of money till his death. So we call it perpetuity. That amount to be received in future till death also can be calculated its value to present. Okay. So these are the techniques of time value of money, where you convert the sums of different time periods into a common time period so that you can compare them and make a decision. Why we are doing it is to make a decision, remember. Okay, so any questions? Any questions here?
No, sir.
Okay. So then what I'm going to do is, so I'll stop share here. Okay. And you can join back the same meeting again. Okay, with the same link, let us log out and log in. Then first I'll take attendance and then I'll go ahead with numerical problems. Initially, the numericals are very small. I hope by this time everybody might
have. Sir.
I can sign out. You can sign out.
Okay, sir.